Hey guys, so we've got the Travelall into the shop, taking up a fair bit of space. It's in here kind of on an angle, and I can't get it back quite as far as I want to because of a hitch that's sticking out. Taking off that hitch is going to be one of the first things that we get to. Basic plan is to strip out the seats from the interior. We'll just kind of toss them out on the driveway for the moment, and then really assess everything and figure out how we're going to make this work. Really, I don't know exactly how I'm going to try and get started fitting all of these pieces together. So come along with me and we'll figure that out on the way. So this is the hefty hunk of meat that was welded up under there. You can see that's a pretty hefty chunk of plate welded to a very small cross member and the bottom of the bumper. So it twisted the whole bumper. You can see how far out that twisted. Some of that was done by us trying to jack up the back of this thing when we were recovering it. We put a jack under that hitch and it just twisted it even farther. Hitch couldn't even hold up the weight of the back end of the vehicle. And then it was welded into that cross member, which was nicely bent. And this cross member behind it, you can see half of it's broken off and pushed backward. I honestly do not know what went on there. That flashlight is right in front of the other half of it. Which you can see right there. So those were once together. I'm not quite sure what all happened there. It's not like it's a spare tire enclosure. The spare tire enclosure is in the rear. So yeah, that was a really, really high quality hitch install that I'm sure could have held quite a bit of weight. That's that chunk of floor that's cut out of the front. So I haven't been stepping on the tailgate because the way the bumper is folded up right here, you can't really see that, can you? The way the bumper is folded through here seems to be causing the tailgate to sit on it. So I don't want to put big old dents in the tailgate any worse than it may already have. You can see this panel was kind of set in after the fact. I'm not completely sure I understand what was going on, how it was assembled, or if these really were welded together right along here and it's just welded completely out. This kind of looks like it was a separate plate for some reason. Got a bolt there, bolt over there, and a strip across the front. And we may be pretty much able to just pull this entire back panel out of this thing and get it out of the way. And then go from there. So let's see what happens. Those seat frames were made out of quarter-inch thick steel plate. Those things weigh more than I ever imagined they would. Good night. Hey guys, so a buddy of mine came over today. Spent a bunch of time destroying the Travelall here. You can see we've wreaked some havoc here on the front end. We got the full front clip torn down, got the firewall totally separated from the body as far as we're going to from the start. Got a bunch of work done on the interior as well. So there's only a little bit more cutting, I think, before we are ready to try lifting the body off. But let's go ahead, take a look at everything we got done today. Got some quality farmer work going on inside this. Maybe a cigarette carton, plastic bag, lots of silicone.
Never had that happen before. Yeah.
you guys a quick tour of that work and where we're at now. I don't know if I'm going to finish getting the body ready to lift off this week or not. We only have a little bit more time we can get some work done in. But where we are right now, got the whole front end stripped off. That's all just kind of stacked over there, as well as the heater box, which I will not be keeping. But hey, maybe it'll be useful to someone. So you can see we stripped the firewall off. Stripped the inner fenders. And those are all just stacked under the front of the vehicle. Cut the firewall. Firewall is cut all the way down to the floor pan. Got some pretty ugly rust right there. Gonna have to take care of. Quite a bit right there as well. This will be coming off. That will not be part of the Tahoe conversion. Up here, this whole cowl is welded in, but that will be part of the conversion, so we'll probably end up having to cut it free to get some work done, and then welding it back in or making it bolt in, I'm not sure. One thing that was interesting, the wiper transmission is completely loose, totally functional, and like turns by hand. That was pretty cool. I don't know that we'll be using any portion of that wiper transmission, but it's loose and clean, so good there. Coming inside. Dash is all totally stripped, wiring pulled down. We've separated everything that would connect the upper body up here from the floor pan and firewall. So we've separated all of those elements. Those are all gonna, should be able to come apart now. You can see that cut over there. All of that is actually cut down as well. Cutting back along here so that the floor pan and the inner rocker are apart. This body mount here, there's no floor connected to it at all anymore, but it does connect to the inner rocker of the body, so we're going to leave the body mount intact for now. Finished cutting all the way back. Ugh. So that all of this is separate from the inner rocker. And then this sort of reinforcement box, torque box maybe, it sat right under the mounts for the rear seat, so maybe it was just there to stiffen the floor pan for that. Cut around that mount so that can just stay with the body and I'll cut it out later. I'll have to do the same over on that side. There's another box under here, which is why that's all cut. You can kind of see the box a little bit right there. You can see the edge of that box. The other side of it's under here. So we've cut that loose so that that chunk of floor pan will just come up with the rest of the body. You can see a bunch of the stuff that we extracted today just sort of all piled in here. We just sort of threw stuff out of the way as we got it loose. And then back here, right there is a body mount that attaches to from the body to the frame, and it actually connects to the shell, not just the floor pan. And there's another one over on the left side. So with a little bit more cutting up there, like we did on the driver's side, to free the floor pan from the inner rocker, and cutting loose the box that we cut there over here, then hopefully the only things left that will be holding the body to this floor pan and frame will be those four mounts. So I've got one here, one over in there, and then the two big body mounts up front that are still connected to the rockers.
So it seems a lot easier to leave those intact for now and lift the body off the frame with those intact, and then I can get in under the body and clean everything up from there. I am still not completely sure how I am going to lift this body high enough to do what I need to do. So that's one of the things we're going to have to figure out. So stick around, see if maybe you guys can help me come up with an idea if the next couple of things I try just don't end up working. Because crushing the fenders or the rockers on this thing is a distinct possibility. But it's one we're going to do our best to avoid. Thanks, guys.